Here's the process of sand casting, and the reason we use sand for casting is it'll hold high heat of the molten metal that we're going to add to it. In this case, we're going to be using aluminum. We're going to melt aluminum. So the first thing we need to do is we need to get the sand mixed up, and we need to make it so it'll hold a shape, and that's what's happening here. We're squeezing it in our hand, and it will hold a shape, and that's what we want it to do when we put it into the molding box. Now the sand is added to this drum along with some agents to help bond, such as bentonite, a little bit of water, and some wood. And that's just to hold it together. And then what's going to happen, we're going to put it in this drum, and we're actually going to turn the drum on and mix it up. So now it's mixing, and then we'll take it out the bottom of the drum after all the products are mixed in together. So now the sand is coming out the bottom and it's ready to be used for molding. Here's some sand that's prior to mixing, and you can see that it won't hold a shape. It just slips through his hands. So that's why we're adding the products and mixing it up so it'll hold a form. We need to put the sand into a container. In this case, we have two halves of a box which make the flask. What we have here is the drag, or the bottom half of the flask. And then we will put the top half together with it. And that's the cope, the top half, and together they make a flask. Now what we're going to do is we're going to put a pattern in the middle, and if it sits in the middle of this box, it's called a match plate. So what we have here is the match plate. A couple things I'd like you to notice is the sides on the part that we're actually going to use have a slight taper on them. This is called a draft. If we didn't have this on the side when we went to pull it out of the sand, it would grab the sand and wreck the casting. So this black part here is actually going to be the casting we're going to use. So what we're doing is creating a void in the sand. What we have here in red, we need to make a pathway to get the molten material into the casting. So we have this part here. So what we have are runners. Where they meet the casting of the black part are called the gates. This is called a well. And what happens when the molten material hits the bottom of this, we have a little bit of turbulence, and any foreign material will be caught in this part. It also acts as a reservoir for the casting. If we have a look at the other side here, what we have is we're going to be able to introduce the sand in from the top. Again, this is acting as a reservoir. And we will put a hole in the sand so we can introduce the material into the sand. Here's the match plate being put into the flask, into the middle. Now we're just going to put the top half of the flask on, and we're ready to start pouring sand around this pattern. I'm going to put a little bit of talcum powder on the pattern so the sand doesn't stick to the pattern when we pull it out, before we're ready to introduce the molten material. Now we're going to add some sand, and it's a good idea to sift the sand around the pattern so we don't have any foreign material or big chunks next to the pattern. So what we'll do is put a sifter on top of the flask, and this is just again so we can make sure we don't have any foreign material in the sand next to the pattern. Once the pattern's covered, we can just use coarse sand in that case. So mixing the sand in. We now have this sifted sand sitting on the pattern, and it's actually being packed down around the pattern because the sand will pack tight. The sifted sand also will give us a nicer surface finish on the outside of the casting. So in other words, the sand's not quite so rough. Now that the pattern's covered, we're just going to fill the box up with some loose sand, and we'll pack it in tight around the pattern. He's ready to start packing it down, and he's using this packer in order to get the sand tight. Using the other end to get in tight to the corners of the box. Now that we have the top of the flask packed tight with sand, we need to flatten the sand off so when we flip it over, it becomes a nice flat surface to sit on. So we're just using a steel bar in order to strike off the top of the box or flatten it out. Ready to flip the flask and fill the void in the other half of the flask. So he's going to pack sand around this half of the pattern or the match plate, the piece that's in the middle. Here we are now sifting the sand on the other side of the flask against the pattern. And after the sand is sifted around the pattern, you'll use backing sand or just coarse sand to pack the flask full on this side. So now we're getting the backing sand on this half of the flask, packing it in up to the top, and then again he'll pack it in tight and make it flat on the top or strike it off the top. So now the other half of the flask is packed and he's going to flatten the top off, just scrape the sand off so it's flat with the flask or strike off the top of the box, and then he will be ready to split it and take the pattern out of the middle, leaving the void in the sand. I'll move the flask to another cart and we're going to split the flask in two and take the match plate out of the middle. Got to lift it off very carefully so he doesn't disturb the sand or have it break off. And he's just going to flip it upside down. And he'll remove the match plate from the middle. So if you have a look here, here's the void or the hole in the sand. And what will happen is we'll have molten material come in from the one half of the flask. It'll come down through here, through what's called a sprue, and we have a little bit of turbulence in here for the molten material and any foreign material to get caught. Then it comes in through the runners and in through a gate right here and into the casting. Again, the other half of the box will be on top of this, so this will be totally enclosed. And then what will happen is it will sit in here until the molten material solidifies, and then we'll break the sand apart in order to expose the casting. Okay, now we need to drill a hole through from the inside of the casting to the top, and this is where the molten material will be introduced. You will then flip it over and cut a taper on the top, which is called a pour cup, which just makes it a little wider, so the molten material can be introduced a little easier. And then the two halves of this flask will go back together and it's ready to have the molten material introduced to it. And now to dig out the top of this hole, so you can see the sprue that came right through the top of the casting, and he's just tapering the top of it so we can introduce some molten material a little easier. Then he'll put the two halves of it together and start to pour. Here's the vat with the molten aluminum, and they're just reaching in, they're going to grab the flask of molten aluminum, and then they'll set it down on the tongs in front of it. You can see that it's glowing red hot. They'll scrape the slag off the top of it. So what we have is molten aluminum inside the pot here, and then they'll grab it with the second set of tongs, and we'll bring it over and do a pour.
I'm not going to move it all.
Once he starts to pour the molten aluminum, he wants to keep it going until it fills right up to the top of the flask. And what will happen as it solidifies, it will start to draw back into the flask.
Beauty.
You can see the aluminum up top. And there's the final pour with the molten aluminum right to the top of the flask. It'll sit for a while till it solidifies, then they'll break the flask in two and take the casting out. Here's the flask split apart with the casting after it's solidified, and you can see the hole in the sand. You can see the casting, and you can see the parts that allowed us to get the molten material down to the casting part. So this will all be cut off, and then we'll save the casting. The rest of this will go back into the melting pot. So what we have is we have the sprue, which is the hole that came through to the top of the casting. You can see the line between the two halves of the flask. This is a well, and it's holding molten material to supply it to the casting as it's solidifying. We have a runner that's going from the sprue to the well, and then we have gates that are going into the casting. Now what's going to happen is we're going to cut this off, and then this part will go back into the vat, and this is the casting that's ready to be machined. Good. So here we are using the vertical band saw in order to cut the excess pieces off.